Volunteers in Brevard County are making a difference for abandoned and abused children, but it is a race against time.
Nana's House is a private Christian organization that's trying to help build more space for these children.
New here at 5, WESH TWO'S Dan Bello reports many have to be turned away.
It comes out even with this side right here.
Okay, Megan Valier and her mother Deborah have never built anything before. But they just had to learn because this is for the neediest of children. Children who've been abandoned or sometimes horribly abused.
It breaks my heart. It keeps me up at night. You know, you can't sleep when you're having to turn away a child that you know is being neglected or abused. All right. Well, welcome to our third Nana's House.
Kim Froge runs Nana's House, which provides a loving Christian home to children.
This is our new girls' room.
How far in?
Volunteers are renovating this home because 86 children in need returned away last year because there was no room. With no government funding, the organization runs on donations and love.
Some kids come to us, they've never even been loved before. So you have to teach them how to love. And how else are you going to do that without just showing them and doing it?
You're just seeing all this really amazing stuff being done for the community, you know, and everybody volunteering, and I think it's great.
5 to 10 more children will live here by next month, but Nana's House needs more money, volunteers, and a minivan for the kids.
It's amazing whenever you make a difference like that in a child's life. It's amazing when you can see the transformation right before your eyes. There's no better feeling than that.
There's so much more need than one house can address. But soon, 8 more will be going up in a gated community where 40 kids will live, and all of it will have been built by volunteers. In West Melbourne, Dan Bello, WESH 2 News.